Hi, my name is Michaela Hediger, and today we are going to dissect a sheep eyeball for Anatomy and Physiology, Part 1. Today, here is our sheep eyeball. We went ahead and rinsed our eyeball. We've got our gloves on, got all of our proper tools ready to go. This tissue is exceptionally tough. So I went ahead and I had to go ahead and cut it before we started this video. We were struggling to get into it, so we wanted to make sure we had that all done, ready to go. But if you look on the outside here, we're going to start on the outside. We have our fibrous connective tissue, and we also have our external muscles. So our external muscles are going to help move the eye when it's in the orbit, and the connective and fatty tissues are going to help keep it in place. And here's a good example, a big chunk of fatty connective tissue. And the outermost layer is the fibrous tunic, and that is going to be the outermost, the toughest layer. And then here, right there, is our optic nerve. Really tough little structure, optic nerve. Okay. Flip it back over. Okay, so we have our sclerotia. Are usually it would be white, but considering this has been sitting in preservative, it's more of like a grayish brown. But typically that would be white, and then you would have your cornea, and those layers would kind of be just one. They would join together. Cornea, sclerotia. And now that we've snipped inside, when I opened this, we did get a lot of liquid coming out. That liquid that flowed out of here, as you can see over here, got a bunch of liquid. That is our Aquarius humor, and that comes out of the anterior chamber. Anterior chamber, our Aquarius humor. We have two chambers. We have our anterior and posterior. Anterior is going to house the Aquarius humor, and the posterior houses the vitreous humor right there. Jelly-like substance. And this is our posterior chamber. Jelly-like substance. Okay, let's go back to the front for a second. Anterior and posterior chambers separated by the iris. I think we've already mentioned that. This is going to be our lens. Let's see if I can get this out of here. This is our lens. Here we go. Very bouncy lens, and we'll come back to that here in a minute. Let's see. I can get into this. This eyeball is definitely has some pretty tough structures. Can kind of see right here, this is our iris. This is our iris. And then in the middle of the iris right here would be your pupil. Your pupil. So we have our iris, and this has two sets of muscles. our outermost muscles are going to be the radial muscles. Those are going to dilate. And then the innermost are the circular muscles, and those are going to help constrict the pupil. So we're going to dilate and constrict the pupil with the muscles that are located in the iris. The iris acts as like a sphincter muscle, just kind of like a fun fact. Me personally, I have a physiological anisocoria, so sometimes throughout the day my pupils will be 1 to 2 millimeters different in sizes. And that just kind of, you know, it's based off of these muscles here that are located in the iris. Some constrict more than others. It's actually about 20% common in our population to have that sometime throughout the day. So, try to remove some of this. And if you look in here, got that really pretty turquoisey color that is seen in typically animals. And that is so they have better night vision. That's interesting. Okay. Let's go back over here. And when you look in here, when I'm digging around in here, we've got this real creamy white substance. This creamy white substance, that's actually the retina. And the place where it doesn't want to come off, where it's stuck, that is actually considered your blind spot. So you actually don't have vision right there, but your brain learns to compensate for that, so it's not noticeable. So when we say we have a blind spot, we do, and that's where it's located, is where that retina attaches back there. There's that side. There's that layer right there. Nice turquoisey color. Okay. We're going to go back to our... and here even too, you can see that little nerve. Now we're going to go back to our lens. And if we cut this open, I gotta be real careful because it's real round and bouncy. But if we're able to get this open here, it actually has kind of like onion-like structures in the lens. There we go. If you want to zoom in there, you can actually see those onion-like structures in that lens. Okay. And so usually, like, sometimes when people get cataracts, their lens will get clouded and they'll have to go in there and either change the lens out and put an artificial lens in or break up that clouding. Just kind of another interesting fact, I have actually ICL lenses in my eyes right now, and those are located in the posterior chamber of the eye, and they utilize the natural lens that's in place right now. Over time, when I do develop cataracts with age, those ICL lenses will come out and they will put in a multifocal lens while they're cleaning up those cataracts. But I think that's pretty much it. Very complex, lots and lots of tough tissue. That is for sure. Probably one of the toughest things I've ever dissected. And that concludes our dissection today of the sheep eye.